Okay, this is the first round of the state playoff in 69 in Dothan, a week after the W.S. Neal game. Abbeville and T.R. Miller. Abbeville has got the home field in Rip Hewes Stadium. We're in the white, and they're in the, it's a film, it's a color film. It's a little bit dark, I guess you could say, overexposed or something, and they're in cardinal jerseys, and we were in the white jerseys with red helmets. They finished number one in the state out of the top four teams, and we finished number four. Number one played four, and number two played three. And this is the opening quarter. Their quarterback's back to throw, big guy, and two people that most folks remember on Abbeville's team, Leroy Cook, all Southeastern Conference in. I believe number 88 was a sophomore in this game, and a fullback named Ronnie Joe Barnes all went on to Alabama to play football, and of course Bucky and Mack off our team went to Auburn, and Steve Glass went to Auburn, and maybe some of the other, Greg Gillis went and kicked. This is Greer Horton on 28 sweep, and runs it down in good field position, right. The first series on offense, Bucky handed off to Greer again on a dive play. And we've got a penalty in now. That's old 27 X out pattern to Mack Phillippi. And he runs it down to the 30-yard line. Bucky on the option play and stopped. Comes back and runs Greer on a dive play again. Abbeville had it. The thing I remember about him, it's been a long time, and on the option play and pitching to Greer, they had the largest team we had seen by far all year, and they were undefeated as well as our team. It's November, I don't know, maybe the first week in December in 1969, or at least the last Friday night in November. Bucky back to throw, and I believe that's hit Jimmy McCracken on about the 3-yard line. Greer takes it down to the one. You can see that hit there. That's some kind of football, and Bucky sneaks it in for the touchdown. Greg Gillis kicks it through. I think he kicked that one in the parking lot. So we're leading 7-0. Greg's kicking off. The thing I remember about Greg's kickoffs, I asked him not to kick it in the end zone. Well, maybe we could get a... you can see Lorenzo Jones, number 65. I'm almost positive down there on making a tackle inside the 20. Greg kicked the ball very high, and we were able to get down under it and get some field position inside the 20-yard line. Interception right there by Seal Castafny, number 22. Picked it off, and we're back on offense. Bootleg at 9. Bucky keeps it, runs it down to the 10. Hands it off to Greer, not much running. Back to Lee Kaler on a quick trap. He gets a few yards. We get called for holding. Bucky's on a daylight pattern here, throwing incomplete. Greg Gillis kicking, going, attempting a field goal, is short to the left. So Abbeville takes over and stops us. We're back on defense.
That's under nose guard.
Robert Blackman, Lamar Cook at tackles, Travis Ballard, Mack Phillippi at defensive ends, Gordon Sharon, Steve Glass at linebacker. Greer Hort, number 20, is our strong safety, our monster, I believe we called him back then, a Rover 1. Jimmy McCracken at safety, Seal Castafny at cornerback. Jamie Holland played some corner. That's Travis and Mack in there to block a punt. I'm not sure which one blocked it, but they blocked about six during the year, defensive ends. This is Lee Kaler on a quick trap. Down to about the 4-yard line. Bucky running a 19 sprint. He's going to score. Greg kicking the extra point. It's 14-0 in favor of T.R. Miller. Little spot pass over the head. They threw a lot in this ball game. Had a big quarterback screen pass right there, broken up. So they're forced to punt. We're back on offense again. This is Greer on 20 counter. He hits it kind of wide, but gains some yard. Real quick offensive line. Bucky get trapped on a bootleg and kind of throws it away, I think. Quick pitch to Lee Kaler. He picks up some yard. First down. Bucky got tackled and pitched it on to Greer anyway, and he got knocked down. They did a good job playing defense right there, as you can see. Abbeville Yellow Jackets, they're tough. The screen pass out there to Greer, and he gets behind some blocking. Option pass right here. That's a trick play somebody put in, probably Coach Cotton. Leasing to Mack Philippi out of bounds. And Bucky's back to throw again and pleats it. Can get anything out of that play. That's good defense. Middle screen right here. Lee Kaler. He runs out of his blocking but still gets down to around the 10. Throwing out to Greer in the flat. Pick up first down. Wasn't real cold this ball game either. You see there's people down there with coats on and everything, but like I said, either still probably in the first week in December probably. Bucky throwing in the end zone, incomplete. We're going to tip the field goal. Greg Gillis kicking and Jimmy holding, Jimmy McCracken. And Greg makes it. I think Greg held some kind of record after this game for a few years. I don't know if it still stands. He kicked maybe two field goals and three or four extra points for some type record in the state playoffs as far as scoring by kicking. This is Abbeville back again. Big power football team and got some quick kids from Brutner. It's going to do a good job stopping their offense. Frank Sims at nose guard and Blackburn and Cook at tackles and Ballard and Philippi at ends. Sharon Glass at linebacker. Greer Horton at strong safety. Jimmy McCracken at free safety. And I think the cornerbacks were Seal Castafny and Jamie Holland, although Johnny Booker and Jim Hildreth and Bart Taylor and some other people played in the secondary. We had a lot of people that could play back there and did a good job. Bucky's throwing again right here. It's hemmed up, and he's going to make a heck of a run right here. You can just watch it all over the field. Makes several cuts, picks up, and goes again. I think he's going to score. Well, if I had my old 16 projector now, I'd run that back three or four times and wear it out, but we'll move along. Greg kicks the extra point, and we're leading now 24-0, I believe. Greg kicks off, kicks it real high, drops it down there about the two, and here comes Lorenzo Jones right there, 65. Lorenzo made the tackle and jarred the ball loose, and somebody else got the ball. We got it down around almost the 15-yard line, as you can see. That's Leroy Cook, I can tell you right now. He made some fine catches against us. It's a good sack right there, and good help, good catch by them. Ineligible receiver downfield. Like I said, this is played in Dothan. Rip Hewes Stadium. I wish more games were played like this in the playoff, because it was a mutual site, mutual field there. Neither team's home field, although they were the home team. Good facilities and plenty of seats to prevent them from scoring right there and take over on downs, but they get the best of that series. This is starting, beginning the second half. Abbeville kicks off to us. Score is 24-0 at halftime. I'm not sure who that was returning the ball, but they did a great job. We get a penalty right off the bat, and Bucky completes one to Jimmy McCracken. Quick pitch to Greer Horton. It gets good yardage. Nothing doing in the middle. Good pass to Mack Philippi from Bucky Philippi. We got a procedure penalty. Greer again on 20 counter. Mike Sutton on the draw play. 23. Mike Sutton again on a up the middle. Bucky on an option, pitches it out to Greer. They stop us, and Greg kicks another field goal. He kicked two or three, I'm not sure which, and had two or three extra points. Kicks off again, gets it down deep. Good tackle down there, again by someone. Abbeville ran all out of what we call a strong formation, strong right and left. They fumble right there. We get the ball back, going deep on first down, and Jimmy McCracken catches it for a touchdown that's called back. And then they went to the I formation after that, a lot of what we ran out of. It's a draw play to Greer Horton, number 20. Good blocking over there, and behind Frank Sims and either Steve Glass or Mike Godwin. I know one played quick guard and one played strong. I'm not sure where they wound up, but I have to go back and do a little work on that. Buck is being pressured and has to throw it away. So we line up, attempt another field goal right here. Greg Gillis kicking from a long way out. We wasn't close. Good defense right there. Saw Lamar Cook in on that. I don't know who all else, but I know it was good defense. They're forced to punt. Good crowd at this ball game. Not a big crowd, not a packed house, I mean, but Rip Hewes Stadium seats a lot of people, so it was a good crowd, and I think we had a good crowd on our side, and Abbeville kind of being the home team, and Dothan had a very good crowd. Good pass right there to Jimmy McCracken. good pass right there for a touchdown. Bucket of Jimmy. I didn't realize we threw so much. I must have been younger. Greg kicking an extra point through, and I can't tell what the score is right now. I know it's going to wind up. By 41-14, and what's going to wind up, I'm not sure what it is right at this moment. I know Leroy Cook had two touchdowns, caught a couple of touchdowns in the fourth quarter, maybe. We had some pass interference on him. He still caught them. A good catch right there for one great run. Good sack right there by the defense. I don't know. I believe Leroy Cook was number 82. Like Ronnie Joe Barnes was 33. I know he was a big, strong running back. There's one touchdown right there. A real fine catch. So they get on the scoreboard, and I think probably it's 41-7 at this point. It's third quarter right now, and I'm not sure about the score, but Mike Sutton again on the draw play from Bucky. Mike Sutton was a backup fullback, and a little jump pass to Mack Philippi. Little pop pass, and pass broken up right there, so they take over. They're still throwing, and I remember they threw a lot in this ball game, and certainly completed some good passes, and I think we had a good night. We hadn't played anyone all year quite as physical as a team like Abbeville, and we held our own real good with them. They're forced to punt right there. I think Greer returns it. We ran a 50 defense back in those days. What we really started doing then was what a lot of people are doing now, many years later, is running multiple defenses. We ran an odd and even scheme, and we still do that. See Frankie Sims right there putting the pressure on the quarterback, forcing some movement. Abbeville ran an even defensive scheme, similar to what we'd see against somebody like Monroeville and later on against Aliceville in the state championship game. Got a big quarterback in there now, a real big guy, and still throwing the ball a lot against us. And there's another touchdown right there by Leroy Cook. You see why he went on, was an all Southeastern Conference football player. He caught that one with someone hanging off. They kick an onside kick. Hopefully we get it. Bucky's throwing one away right there, kind of. Greer on 29 sweep. Interference on him. He still caught him. A good catch right there. for one great run. Good sack right there by the defense. I don't know. I believe Leroy Cook was number 82. And like Ronnie Joe Barnes was 33. I know he was a big, strong running back. There's one touchdown right there. A real fine catch. So they get on the scoreboard, and I think probably it's 41-7 at this point. It's third quarter right now, and I'm not sure about the score, but Mike Sutton again on the draw play from Bucky. Mike Sutton was a backup fullback, and a little jump pass to Mack Philippi. Little pop pass, and pass broken up right there, so they take over. They're still throwing, and I remember they threw a lot in this ball game, and